We started back in 2011 getting this car put together, getting who the builders are going to be, and we've put together a really beautiful car that we'll be giving away in Columbus in 2014. It's a 32 tribute car, like Gary Meadors' original 32 that he started the company back in 1984.
Yeah, well, my 32 I bought out of Paradise, California, believe it or not, way back in about 1972. So I've been driving around in it for about 40 years, and it's been driven to and through about 46 different states. So it's a roadworthy campaigner, that's for sure.
Oh, I remember going to Canada with the family, mom and dad and me and my brother in the back seat. And long, painful trip with the family and fighting over the back seat, and you know, he's on my side, and I remember my brother wiped a booger on me and I freaked out, and dad was trying to slap us in the back seat. So those are a lot of good memories in this car with the family.
I'd never seen a 32 two-door done high boy style with a badass stance, and that's what I was after, was making one that really sat right down on the deck in the front, and you know, the big balonies on the back and little ones up front, and all that kind of stuff. So that was my image of what I thought was the next deal. So I called Dick and I said, Dick, I'd like to do this thing as a high boy 32, and he saw, man, I'm the guy.
Well, it was typical 32 body, 32 two-door, did the whole McGillicuddy. Did everything but paint, and of course Sam did the painting and finishing on it, but we did the chassis and we built it to be a driver, and I don't think that thing has stopped since, and that's what a street rod should be.
A car is a very personal thing, so I mean, that's the way I create them. They're personal. Everything's got to work together. You got to keep it simple, clean. Simplicity is elegance. And that's the way Gary's car was built. I mean, I've been building cars for 60 years, and it's nice when somebody comes up and says, I really like your work and stuff. It makes you feel good. And a lot of things that I've done in the past, they've been copied, and it doesn't upset me. I think, hey, that's great. They like what I did. You know, if you're copied, that's very much a compliment.
We're going to be picking up the car today, and we're mid-November 2011, and that car is to be delivered about a year from now. So we'll give it back to them before Thanksgiving of 2012, and they're going to tour it for a year, and then it goes to a new owner.
Ed emailed me one day and wanted to know if I had one or knew of one that was for sale, a 32 body, and he explained to me what they were going to do, and I had a couple in the barn sitting down there, so... I volunteered. It's probably as good a 32 sedan body as you'll find from a rust and beat up standpoint. There'll have to be no patch panels put in it. All the rust in the grip rail molding, there is none. There's no rust in the car anywhere. We've got a number of young men that's in this industry now that still have an eye for cars that people like me like to look at. They still know old cars. You know, they know what an Auburn dash is. You know, they know what kidney bean wheels are. And the builders that we have in the business now have taken car building to a level that we never dreamed it could be done.
Yeah, I'm a little blown away to actually be included, and it's pretty impressive to be with a lot of legends of my industry. But Gary's car is so iconic that you don't really want to change too much from that. From 30 yards back, you're going to think you're looking at Gary's original 1932 logo car for Goodguys, but as you get closer, you'll know I'm going to add a little bit of a dimension to the grill. We're going to chop the top, much like the original car. The graphics are going to resemble from far away the exact same. The wheels will even look like that same, but a little bit bigger diameter, a little bit more drop, a little more stretch. It's going to be really a cool looking car. know, we're building a good quality car, you should be able to drive it. And that's something that that we definitely know that that's going to be important with this car, is that it's to be driven. The drivability is going to be gained by using a Pinky's chassis, a GM Performance crate motor, the Ramjet 350, the 4L65E, which is easy to tune and program. This car, technically speaking, should drive just like a brand new Cadillac or, you know, Mercedes. There shouldn't be really a whole lot of difference. And of course, if you pull the trigger, I think it'll do a burnout.
We want somebody driving this car for the next 10 or 20 years. That's our goal, is for them to put hundreds of thousands of miles on it, like what Gary has done with his 32. He's got 267,000 miles on his, and we want this one to be just like that one and be all over the country.